What do you feel when you're attached to somebody, attached to a girl, to a woman? It's a tremendous feeling. It's the same thing. It's my woman. Really. It's like in music.
Decades of decline and a multi-million dollar restoration, Henry Shaw's museum is opening once again at the Missouri Botanical Garden. The documentary, A New Leaf, Reimagining Henry Shaw's Museum, shows the process as the museum is brought back to its original glory. Now, our guest joining us might look a little bit familiar
to
you.
Original glory.
You are. That's perfect.
You got new carpeting. It's pretty great.
Oh, yeah. So we've done a few updates here. Paul Shankman joining us again has been a reporter at Fox 2. Now you've moved on. You're doing documentaries.
Yeah.
I mean, I just saw a little snippet. It looks fantastic. What is this about?
Well, it's called A New Leaf, Reimagining Henry Shaw's Museum. And what we did was for 18 months, we followed the restoration of Henry Shaw's museum. And people, even St. Louisans, are probably going, Henry Shaw had a museum?
Ooh, yeah.
You've walked by it 1,000 times if you've been to the garden. Nobody ever noticed it because it's been closed to the public since 1890.
Okay.
The garden grew so fast that his museum, which he thought would be there for the ages, was outdated by 1890. And so it's just been kind of sitting there, rotting away. They did a few things with it. They tried to put a restaurant in there, and they did some science experiments. But basically, it's one of the most beautiful buildings in St. Louis, and certainly historically significant. And no one had done anything with it until Peter Weiss Jackson took over the garden about 2010 and said, hey, we should do something with this.
Yeah.
And so they did. We followed it, and they had lots of surprises along the way.
What were some of the things that you didn't expect to find or get into as you started the process?
Well, the one thing that they didn't expect to find was they were tearing down a ceiling in sort of what the lobby area, the entrance area of the thing. And it was just a ceiling from like the 1930s that they'd put over the original ceiling. And when they started pulling it down, they found all these portraits that had been painted on the plaster ceiling. One of them had fallen apart. It was laying in pieces on top of the drop ceiling. And so they had to figure out, that wasn't in the plan. What are we going to do with this? And who are these guys? And they didn't even know there were three of them eventually that they found, but they thought they just found the one and thought they, eureka, right?
Yeah.
And then the second one, and then they found the third one in pieces. The other thing that was the marquee project of this was that the top of the ceiling in the main room of the museum was covered by a beautiful fresco that was painted by one of the top muralists of the time in the 1860s. But it had been painted over in the 1930s, and no one was exactly sure what was underneath or how to get to it and try to recreate it. And so they had to strip off the paint, and then they had to make all these scientific drawings, and parts of it were missing because the plaster had fallen. And so they sent all that to New York, and these muralists that I think you saw in the video there got together and put it back together and put it on canvas almost like wallpaper, and then brought it all back to St. Louis and stuck it back on the ceiling.
Wow.
It was spectacular.
It is. And so people can see this, and we have all the information that you can check out online if you want to check out this documentary. It sounds fascinating, and it's a local St. Louis, and it'll be great. The screening for it is Saturday, July 20th.
That's right.
Correct? Fantastic. All right, and again, we'll put all the information online so people can come check it out. We're gonna head to break and hopefully convince Paul in that time to stick with us at Fox 2 forever. We'll see.